Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to St. Stephen's Episcopal Church as we worship together here in person and at home online. This is the very first Sunday we celebrate the season of creation. We are absolutely delighted to have you with us on this long weekend. And we invite you, if you're new to us, to look around, pay attention to the folks around you, ask questions if you have any, and follow along as you are able. Let us know when you're not, and we'll help you out. Our service continues in the first page of this purpley covered booklet. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. May God be with you. Let us pray. God of all love and glory, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your creation, increase in all true unity, nourish the world with all goodness, and bring forth the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ, the wisdom of creation, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated for the lessons.
The first lesson is The Gift by Mary Oliver, a poem. Be still, my soul, and steadfast. Earth and heaven both are still watching, though time is draining from the clock, and your walk that was confident and quick has become slow. So be slow if you must, but let the heart still play its true part. Love still as once you loved, deeply, and without patience. Let God and the world know you are grateful that the gift has been given. Hear what the Spirit is saying through the poet.
Thanks be to God.
As we read Psalm 146, please read the parts in bold. Alleluia, praise God, O my soul. Put not your trust in rulers, nor in any child of earth. When they breathe their last, they return to earth. Happy are they who have the God of Jacob for their help, who made heaven and earth, the seas, and all that is in them. Who gives justice to those who are oppressed? God sets the prisoners free and opens the eyes of the blind. God loves the righteous and cares for the stranger. God shall reign forever.
The second reading is from This Here Flesh, Spirituality, Liberation, and the Stories That Make Us by Cole Arthur Riley. Have you ever stood in the presence of a tree and listened to the wind pass through its leaves? The roots and body stand defiant and unmoved, but listen. The branches stretch out their tongues and whisper, "Shh." Trees make symphonies without their trunks ever moving, almost as if the stillness of their centers amplifies their sound. The tree may appear still, but if you look closer, you will see that each leaf flails with breath. The tree may seem alone, but plow deep and you'll unearth its secret gnarled roots, the grotesque, the beautiful, creeping in the soil, reaching towards the ancestors. Thomas Merton said, "No writing on the solitary meditative dimensions of life can say anything that has not already been said better by the wind in the pine trees." I hold this close. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines. You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition.'" Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come: fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they can defile a person." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. You may be seated. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So this morning we kick off the season of creation, joining with our brothers and sisters across the Episcopal Church and much of the Anglican Communion, we dedicate ourselves and our worship to honoring God's creation. It's an opportunity to get ourselves in right relationship with nature, to fine-tune our understanding of how we fit into the greater whole of all that surrounds us. It's a chance to reaffirm our commitment to live in balanced and life-giving ways with all of God's creation, which is an overwhelming prospect. And it's my hope that the weekly themes will help guide us. This week, we begin with the theme, pray. Engaging creation begins by paying attention with a mix of care and curiosity, opening ourselves to a deeper relationship with the created world. Before we consider what we have to learn, what we might do in response, and how we might advocate on behalf of those with no voice, first, we pay attention. We begin with a posture of openness, ready to receive, to be astonished, to cherish, and to be changed. The essence of prayer. We begin by intentionally taking time. It doesn't have to be a lot of time, but it helps not to be in a hurry. I have a friend who challenged herself to spend 10 minutes outside every day, not doing anything, just being outside. 10 whole minutes of silence in which she could listen to creation, to God, to the resonance of her own soul. She had 3 kids in school at the time and found it difficult to set any time aside for herself. But she did, and was astonished by how it changed her. This intentional time lowered her anxiety, grounded her in gratitude, and helped her breathe deeply. Maybe that's not what you need. Maybe what you need is to walk with a friend every morning, paying attention to how things are constantly changing, even though you walk that same path every day. Maybe you'd rather play something similar to my family's game, Today's Tiny Thing, using your phone to take a photo of some new discovery each day. Recognizing that the game is really about spending quality time and attention, stepping into the world curious about what today's discovery might be. A feisty hummingbird, a tiny flower, a spider web glinting in the sunlight, a feather resting on a leaf of the hydrangea, a baby mouse so small, an iris about to unfurl, that brown bunny who lives in the backyard and basically thinks it belongs to him, a dragonfly, a portion of a robin's egg, bumblebees and honeybees, a tiny toad, a monarch butterfly. Friends, the challenge, if we are willing to accept it, is to pay attention, to engage the created world with hearts willing to fall in love over and over again, to expect to be astonished by what we'll find. Why? Why does any of this matter? Why would we bother in our busy lives? We pay attention to gain much-needed perspective, to keep us from living with those blinders on, too tightly focused on the prize, on achieving the corporate, commercial, competitive goals set before us. In reality, these things we're told to value are shallow and empty. They bring us very little. When we look to creation instead, we discover something more. It's part of turning ourselves from human things toward divine things. It's God's will that we have abundant life, that we find joy and life together with creation, not at the cost of creation. When we immerse ourselves in the wonders of the created world, our hearts expand, our self-absorption falls away, and life becomes truly more abundant, more joyful. So this morning, we're going to practice. Really, I'm serious. Together. We'll need a little imagination and some geography. Here's the plan. First, imagine our four-way intersection at the top of Park Square, with North and South Streets as one axis and East and West Streets as the other. It's really amazing. The city of Pittsfield has done this for us. They made it really easy. With Pittsfield divided into four quadrants, let's consider creation's gifts surrounding us. In the southeast, we have Housatonic Valley Nature Preserve, Canoe Meadows, October Mountain, and further out, near and dear to our hearts, in Hinsdale, Lake Ashmere. Add your own favorite spots in that quadrant. We're talking southeast. What have I missed? Looking for actual answers here. There you go. What else? Nice. I missed one. Nice. Okay, hold those thoughts. Turning to the southwest, we have Bosque Mountain, Richmond Pond, Pleasant Valley Wildlife Preserve, Stockbridge Bowl. What else? Hancock Shaker Village. Nice, the quarry. Anoda. I actually put Anoda in a different quadrant, but it's a good one. My geography is a little shaky. You'll know that about me. Oh. Richmond Pond. In the northwest, there's Lake Anoda, so that's where I put Lake Anoda. Pontusic Lake. And the Pittsfield State Forest. What else is over there? The rail trail, yeah. The name of which no one can say. I know, it's really hard. We just go Azure at our house. I missed it. Nice, the Treasure Reservoir. Ooh. Balance Rock. Everyone's nodding. That sounds like a good one. Okay, we have one more quadrant. The northeast. Mount Greylock, Wakona Falls State Park, Windsor State Forest, and what's over there? Yeah, Springside. I missed it. Okay. Bellevue Falls, nice. Yeah, it's sort of everywhere though, right? The Appalachian Trail we're talking about, just kind of. So friends, did we miss anything? A place that you appreciate, but your geography is like, I don't know which quadrant she's talking about. Your favorite place. That's pretty, the Riverwalk. There's a river behind David's house that's really beautiful. Okay.
What tree stands
your tree stand in the woods. So our homework this week is relatively simple. It's to take time to pay attention, to open our hearts to creation with gratitude, willing to be astounded over and over again. And if you're an overachiever, and some of you obviously are, you can visit one of the places we named aloud this morning and take it in. Breathe deeply of God's grace and gifts that surround and sustain us. And lastly, beloved, because no sermon on creation is complete without a word from Mary Oliver, the guru of paying attention to nature, her poem, Look and See. This morning at waterside, a sparrow flew to a water rock and landed, by error, on the back of an eider duck. Lightly it fluttered off, amused. The duck, too, was not provoked, but you might say was laughing. This morning, a gull sailing over our house was casually scratching its stomach of white feathers with one pink foot as it flew. Oh, Lord, how shining and festive is your gift to us if we only look and see. Amen. Our affirmation of faith is on page 2 in your booklet. Page 2. Let us say together in faith, we believe in God who creates all things, who embraces all things, who celebrates all things, who is present in every
Eternal God, we thank you for the beauty of the world, for the teeming life of the seas, the flight of birds, the diversity of animal life. Grant us grace to treat creation with respect and care, to protect endangered species, to preserve the variety of habitats, and to honor the delicate balance of nature. God of life, we thank you for the wealth of blessings from land and sea, for the power of wind and the warmth of sun. We pray for the nations of the earth. Give us will to cherish this planet and to use its resources sustainably for welfare of all. God of justice, we pray for the faithfulness, witness of the church called to reconcile and heal. For this parish, for Nina, our rector, for Douglas, our bishop, and Michael, our presiding bishop. Grace, God of grace, We pray for the human family. We exult in our diversity and giftedness. We repent our sins, divisions, and violence. By the power of your Spirit, restore your image within us. Every human being is known and loved by you. May we care for one another in love and respect. We pray for those committed to our care, especially those on our prayer list. We pray for Ken, Tommy, Keith, Marcus, Sabka, Mike, Will, Jennifer, Judy, Marty, Valerie, Ann, Mark, Sam, Pat, Becky, Susan, James. We pray for just peace for Ukraine and for those affected by the violence in Israel and Palestine. Please add your own intercessions. God of compassion, we pray for those who have died, for whom we entrust to your eternal love. May we support and comfort those who mourn. God of peace.
Prayer. O merciful Creator, your hand is open wide to satisfy the needs of every living creature. Make us always thankful for your loving providence and remembering the account that we must give one day. Grant that we may be faithful stewards of your good gifts. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. And friends, this weekend is Labor Day weekend, as you know. Let us pray the collect for Labor Day. It's not printed in front of you. Sorry. Almighty God, you have so linked our lives with one another that all we do affects, for good or ill, all other lives. So guide us in the work we do, that we may do it not for self alone, but for the common good. And as we seek a proper return for our own labor, make us mindful of the rightful aspirations of other workers and arouse our concern for those who are out of work. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray for the forgiveness of our sins. God of all mercy, we confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that ensnares us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior, Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you. Please greet one another with the sign of peace. Peace to those of you at home. Peace. Peace. Peace.
All right, let's sit down for a second. I'm going to ring the bell for the fifth and final pop-up choir Sunday. Here we go. right, that's the first note of hymn 335. Would you please turn to 335? No, it isn't. First of all, some people have come up to me and said, I know what you're doing. You're trying to get more choir members. And, you know, I've been saying no strings attached. There's been no strings attached. However, if you were to be interested in singing in the choir, this is a good time of year to think about joining it. And we're going to be starting rehearsals on Wednesday, I think it's September 11th or yeah, I think it's the 11th at 4 p.m. And you know, we don't practice the hymns too much because generally we know them, but we work on the service music and then the various anthems that we sing, and we work in singing in parts. So it's a different thing, but it's a lot of fun, and I've heard some pretty good voices come up here to the front. So I think there are people who could do this. And the choir, you know, they're not a bunch of stuck-up people. They look serious on Sunday morning, but it's sort of like a restaurant. Everything goes great in the restaurant, but in the kitchen at the rehearsal, life is different. All right. Thanks to Josie Ellis, who thought this idea up to have a pop-up choir. And thank you to the vestry for modeling walking up here to sing. I was around the first Sunday. They were a little nervous. Thanks to Nina for selecting the hymns. And while the piano is an inanimate object that has a personality and it doesn't like changes in the weather, so I'm really glad that the piano came through here. Hymn 335 is everything you could possibly want in a hymn. And it's Jesus' words, and he's using a metaphor to talk about spiritual nourishment and salvation. The only problem is that the verses are a little unpredictable. So Jeff is here to help. And then when you come up for the last hymn, you just need the hymn that's in your bulletin. There is a version of this in the hymnal that no one on earth knows. So I always put this version in. And this hymn is a happy hymn, and it really talks about God's creation in the way creation was intended, but it's not actually what creation is like. So much music that is sung is based on hope and what we hope it could be like. Even if it's a romantic relationship, it's probably not perfect. Okay. All right, please come up now with your hymnal and let's sing 335.
So this is our crazy experiment, for those of you who are new. And we just come over and sing around the piano. Come on over, it's fun.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. The Great Thanksgiving begins on page 5 in your booklet. Please know, as always, everyone is welcome to receive from God's table. God be with you. Lift up your hearts to our God. Let us give thanks to the God of all creation. Praise and thanks are yours, our creating God. From the dust of the earth, you shaped human beings in your own image, and you filled the earth and seas and skies with a myriad of wonders. Yet we consistently turn your generosity into our scarcity, your elegance into our meanness, and your simplicity into our corruption. Though we poison and destroy your good creation, you continue to offer us your abundance. In your mercy, you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus, transforming death into life. Through the Spirit, you continue to call us into covenant with you for the restoration of creation and the reconciliation of all people. And so we give you thanks, rejoicing with all of creation as we join the saints and angels in their unending hymn. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and gave thanks to God. He broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take and eat, for this is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." He took the wine and gave thanks to God. He gave it to his friends, saying, "This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink of the wine, do this in remembrance of me." So we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Merciful God, we come to this table seeking reconciliation with you, with one another, with all creation. Through these mysteries, reconcile us to our world, and empower us to restore your creation and fulfill your will. Send your life-giving Spirit upon us and upon this bread and wine. Stir in us the creative and redeem the destructive. Heal your stricken world, that the soil, the skies, and the seas may be filled with your life anew. Fill every heart with the sure and certain hope that we shall enter into the fullness of your joy, when your whole creation is justified by faith and sanctified by love, and you are all in all, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ. In the unity of the Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, everlasting God, now and forever. Amen. In faith and confidence, let us pray the Lord's Prayer in any language or version. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Our post-communion prayer is on page 9 of our booklet. Let us pray. Create in us a new heart and a new vision, O God, that the gifts of your Spirit may work in us and renew the face of the earth. May we be one with you, so that our work is yours and your work is ours. Lead us to transform our lives to reflect your glory in creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who is alive with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. May the Creator watch over you. May the Spirit guide and lead you. May Jesus be present in all that you do. And the grace of our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen. You may be seated for some announcements.
Good morning. My name is Bill O'Neill. I'm the vestry person on duty today. And that means I have the privilege of answering any of your questions, receiving any of your suggestions, and noting any new ideas that you may have for the church, the service, and how we worship together. Also, I'd like to welcome you to the first day of September, and welcome you to St. Stephen's. Most of my job for announcements is done in the bulletin, but I'll hit a couple of highlights. As you can see, office hours are changing. Next week will be a coffee hour. We will be inside, not on the sidewalk. Sunday Fun Day is coming up on the 23rd, so if you know anybody who would like to go to what we used to call Sunday school, that's the time to bring them. I'm also going to start a rumor today. Pop-up choir is going to be replaced, I think, perhaps with pop-up suppers, rather. So dust off those old cookbooks, find your hot meals, and be ready to bring them in on short notice. And finally, and this is my lead in to Nina, Sunday the 29th, we're going to have a service at 10:30 on the Common.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe you can provide some more clues as to that.
So apparently, back in the day, we like to say that in the church, back in the day. On the fifth Sunday of the month, we used to have a service all together with the downtown churches. And we don't do that anymore. I think it was probably a lot doing it every fifth Sunday. But we thought the campus of downtown churches like to do this like once a year. And so we're going to meet together with the other downtown churches on the 29th Sunday at 10:30. It's kind of the middle range between when all our different services meet, and that was what we got to. It was 10:30. We'll be at the Common, and the rain location will be Zion. So just head to the Common. There's parking right there, which is free and available on Sunday right there on that lot. And head across the street, and if we're set up outside, it's outside, and if we're not set up outside, walk into Zion. It'll be fun, it's different, and you get a chance to like meet people, talk to people that maybe you haven't seen in a while, or meet some new friends. We'll have a meal following that together. That's still coming together. We all were volunteering things, and I volunteered us to provide a sheet cake, because that's easy. And the folks over at AME Zion next door, their pastor runs a barbecue place when he's not their pastor, and he is breaking out the smoker. So you don't want to miss the meal. Like, come on over. It's going to be amazing. So more information as we have it. There is a choir that is getting together to sing for that, and that information is in your bulletin. They normally meet on Monday evenings, but they're going to meet Tuesday because of the holiday this week. And after this Tuesday, they're going to sort of close the all come call because they're practicing together. And so if you want to join, make sure you're there this Tuesday so that you can be part of this joint worship choir. Was there anything else I needed to add, Bill?
No.
Okay.
Well, thank you.
Oh, information on the readings is there. I know this is a funny season, right? We pull different readings. We have a funny service. But it's just different, and it's fun sometimes to do something different. So the more information on the readings will always be in the back of the insert so that if you want to know something more, you can look it up and find out more. All right. This is our last pop-up moment of the whole summer. Let's go out with a bang. Come on over to the... You need this from your insert.
Thank you.
Let us bless our God and all creation. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.